is your 10-minute plug-in from MBN, and I'm your host for today, Ambassador Joyce Murigi. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you may be listening from, and you're welcome. You are welcome to our 10-minute plug-in, and I'm your host for today, Ambassador Joyce Murigi. I'm broadcasting from our studios in East Africa, and I live in a place called Kenya. This is where we are broadcasting from today. Welcome, welcome, welcome to our 10-minute plug-in, and be that digital or media ambassador or evangelist. Please share this video so that other people can get to see and can get to listen to the word of the Lord today. Thank you, thank you. I see that I'm being joined by my sister, Lady V. How are you? How is Savannah, Georgia? Welcome to the house of the Lord, and thank you for tuning in. Hello, hello, hello. You're welcome, you're welcome. Be that media evangelist. Share this video with others so that they can get to be blessed with us, with the word of the Lord that He has prepared for us today. Thank you, thank you, thank you for joining. Thank you. And this is the day the Lord has made. This is the hour that the Lord has made so that we may be glad and rejoice in it. And without further ado, I will get started because we don't have much time. We only have 10 minutes and 1 minute is over. So yesterday was a busy day. We celebrated women. We celebrated women and especially mothers. It was actually Mother's Day. So many people say that this day was being celebrated in the US, but you know what? Sometimes when something is good, it spreads out to the whole world, and every person that I talked to from different parts of the world talked about Mother's Day. I was wished a beautiful and a good Mother's Day by very many people, but then I could not stop but to think about very many other mothers out there, or very many other women out there who get forgotten, or who are hiding themselves in shame, or shame has put them behind life and behind everybody else, and so they need to come out. And when I was thinking about the women who are like that, or mothers who are like that, my thoughts and my mind took me to two stories in the Bible. The first story is for of the woman who was had an issue with blood for 12 years, who touched the hem of Jesus Christ, and she was healed instantly. The other story is the story of Hannah and Peninnah, that shame put them where they were. But you know what? Faith took them out from their hiding place. Faith took them out from their shame. Faith took them out from, where they had been hidden by this shame. And they came out, and God put in their mouths a new song, a song, equivalent, or like the one that was sung by Mary when she received the news of her conceiving through the Holy Spirit. So I will just touch on these stories, and then we can get to see the lessons that we are learning. So Mark chapter 5, verse 25 and to 34. The story is told of Jairus. Jairus was one of the priests in the synagogue. So one day, when Jesus, of course, was doing his mission, and he was there, he was in the neighborhood, Jairus pleaded with Jesus Christ to go into his house and lay hands onto his daughter who was dying. And of course, Jesus, decided that he was going. And when he was going to Jairus's house, and the crowds were surging towards him, there was this one woman who was bleeding, or who had bled for 12 years. He had seen different doctors, and he was not getting any help. In fact, the Bible says that his problem only became worse. But she told herself, or she talked to herself and said, if I could only touch the hem or I mean his clothes, Jesus' clothes, maybe I'll get better. And of course, she moved forward behind the crowds. Actually, the Bible says that she came from behind the crowds and she touched the clothes of Jesus Christ and she was instantly healed. And of course, Jesus Christ felt the power come out from him. And when the power came out from him, he asked the crowd, who touched me or who touched my clothes? And the crowds were, of course, you know, dismayed. They didn't know what to say. And his disciples told him, I mean, Master, how can you even ask who has touched the hem of your garment or your clothes? Because the crowds are huge and, you know, we can't know. But Jesus looked around because he was so sure that somebody touched him. And this woman came and trembling in fear, gave an account of what happened. So that is the story of this lady, of this woman who had bled for 12 years. We have to ask ourselves, what lessons are we learning from this story? Or what lessons do we learn from this story? And number one of the lessons is that sometimes we have to come from behind. You know, I started by saying that shame puts us behind. Shame puts us, you know, behind or down. And so we have to come from down. We have to come from behind. And we have to boldly come out in faith and seek the Lord. So that is lesson number one. Lesson number two is that, yes, we must step out in faith, but more so believing that even the slightest encounter, even the smallest encounter with Jesus Christ of the Lord will set us free from our shame. Then we also have to have a meeting with ourselves. We have, you know, to have a meeting and see the possibilities of Jesus meeting us at the points of our needs. Then we must also see ourselves. There is another day that Lady V talked about God seeing us. But you know, we must also ask ourselves, do we see ourselves? Because before God sees us, we need to see ourselves. This woman saw herself first. And she, you know, she talked to herself and said, if only I could touch his clothes, then I would be healed. So we need to see ourselves first before we even boldly step out. Before we think that God is going to see us, we must see ourselves first. Then the other story, I will go very quickly to the story of Hannah. In 1 Samuel, 1 Samuel chapter 1 and verse 2 to 20, the story is told of Hannah. Hannah, who was ridiculed, humiliated, treated badly by her co-wife Peninnah because she was childless. And she was sad, she was desperate. And, you know, one of the days when they had gone somewhere where her husband used to offer sacrifices to the Lord, she went to the house of prayer. She went to the house of the Lord and she started praying to God. She was not even uttering any words, or making any sound, but her lips were moving. Then there was a priest called Eli there. And you know, when he saw Hannah making movement with her lips, Eli was a priest. Eli thought that Hannah was drunken. And when he told Hannah, to get out, to get up, and, because she looks like she was drunk, Hannah told him that, no, I am not drunk. I am here pouring my problems or my tribulations to the Lord, my troubles to the Lord. I am here praying to him because I have been sad. And then she also, the Bible says that she told Eli that do not think that I am worthless. So Hannah knew who she was also. She knew that she was worthy. So Eli told her, may God of Israel give you what you are asking for. And that day she went back home and she was able to eat and she was at peace. Then the following day before they went back home, they worshiped the Lord and that evening she conceived. And of course she became pregnant and she gave birth to a son called Samuel. Samuel, you know, meaning that I asked him from the Lord. And when I was also looking at this story of Hannah, with their lessons that we need to learn, as women who are coming from behind or coming from shame, that we must know ourselves. We must know our worth in God. We must know our worth in Jesus Christ. And we must put a prayer, a constant prayer on our lips. And we must know what we need specifically. Hannah saw this and she went to the Lord with a specific prayer. She saw herself first also, just like the woman with the issue of the blood. She also saw herself and she saw what she needed from the Lord. And the power of God came to her and she conceived. This story reminds me of Psalm 34 and verse 17, where it says that the righteous cry out to the Lord and he hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. Hannah poured out to the Lord. He poured her troubles to the Lord, and the Lord surely delivered her. You know, when Hannah told Eli that she was pouring her troubles to the Lord and the Lord delivered her, this actually matches that verse that I have read, Psalm 34 and verse 17. But let me ask you right away, what kind of shame are you behind? What kind of shame is putting you down? What kind of shame is putting you off balance? What kind of shame is depressing you? What kind of shame is making you sad? Is it being childless? Is it that people are ridiculing you? Is it that you are having so much shame at work? Is it because of your body size or how you look? What kind of shame is keeping you down or putting you behind other people? We have been today reminded that we need to come out boldly and face our fears, face our shame, because we need to give them to the Lord. And we need to keep our focus on the Lord and not on what anybody else is saying or where our shame is putting us. And finally, that we are going to get this song that Mary sang. I would have read it, but because of the for the sake of time, I can't read it. But it is in Luke chapter 1, verse 46 to 51. Mary said that my soul glorifies the Lord and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. May this song be in your lips, because from now henceforth, we know how to step out boldly and focus on the Lord and not on our shame. God bless you. It has been so wonderful to have you in the house, and I hope you are blessed, because I have been blessed. And until next time, when I will see you at the top, see you and God's blessings. Let us meet at the top where eagles fly. God's blessings, and I love you. Bye-bye.